Now, since a lot of you are moving off to college, I'll tell you about a time that I was in college at UCLA. We were in a frat house pushing a couch into a fire. Excuse me, class. Holy grail. Hello?
Matthew Davis!
Oh, hey, Kushmaster.
Matthew, I told you about calling me that. Oh, sorry. What up, dog? Anyways, my best student has been kidnapped.
But I thought I was your best student.
What are you talking about? You got 4 on the AP test. We drive for 5.
Okay, point made.
As I was saying, my best student has been kidnapped. Our old friend Annie Saltzman has decided to take his promised revenge.
Oh, is that the guy that punked you on the golf course?
What? No. The guy who called me after I disqualified Lawrence Ree at the CIF qualifiers. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah, I remember now.
The day has come, Matthew. My favorite student is in jeopardy. I have come to you in my time of need. I entrust you with this. You are my protege. I have given you many of my characteristics, from my dialect, even to my driving. You are practically me.
Ah, shucks. You're right.
Now, the only information that I have is that the athletic director has locked him into a cryogenic freezer. You are going to have to use Newton's law of cooling to find out how much time he has before he freezes to death.
Got it.
Matthew, you know how you have the potential to be great. You just have to pay attention to the details. You have to bring him back safe. Good luck, Matthew, and in the words of my uncle, I believe in you!
Don't worry, Kushi. You can count on me.
Is something wrong, Mr. Davis?
No, but Ryan, I need you to watch the class.
But I'm the only one here.
Oh, Ryan, also spit out your gum.
You little nitwit. I heard Devin sent you. I already know you're gonna lose, so I'll even tell you where we have your friend. We're at my grandfather's restaurant, the Macaroni Grill. Come at me, you lower class golfer. You can't even hit these balls. By the way, we're gonna have a spectator. Lawrence Ree will be joining us tonight. Time's ticking for your friend and toward my unavoidable victory. I hope you brought tissues.
Listen up, you scumbag. I've been taught by none other than Devin Kushi himself, and have an arsenal of calculus at my disposal. Now I will find you, and I will teach you a lesson in Newton's law of cooling.
Good luck. Pembroke, it's time for my afternoon shower. Oh, money.
My dude, my car. Look at it!
Dude, where did you even come from? It's like you fell out of the sky. Okay, be cool, man. Be cool.
You will drive for the 5.
What? What does that even mean?
The freeway, what'd you think I meant?
I don't know what the five, okay.
I'm very in a hurry. I'll explain all this later in 4 separate emails at 4 a.m., complete with news about the girls' golf alumni. Okay?
Okay.
Remember, drive for 5.
You wait here. I come back later.
Okay.
Welcome, Mr. Davis. I'm surprised you made it this far.
Yeah, we didn't think we would make it this far, because you suck!
Wait, what? No, there's no trouble at all. There's just a little traffic on the 5.
Look, I'm still gonna beat you. 3 under par.
Yeah, 3 under par! Oh!
Wait, is Lawrence just here to repeat everything you say?
No, like I said, he's here to spectate my inevitable victory.
I'm here to spectate his inevitable victory! Yeah!
You know what? Hit me. Make my day.
Saltman, do you surrender?
Not yet. Lawrence, give this plebeian his money back.
Brothers! It burns! Oh, gosh darn it! Oh, wait, the student! Oh. Hey! Where's the freezer? Where are you keeping it?
Right there.
Oh, I guess I wasn't paying attention to the details.
Explain it to me! How do I get it open?
Okay. You gotta use the Newton's Law of Cooling. I'll tell you how it's like.
Okay, this is Newton's Law of Cooling. Lowercase t is time, y is in temperature, k is a constant, and capital T is room temperature. We then solve the integral and let w minus v equal z. Cancel out the natural log, rearrange the equation. Let e to the z equals p. Optionally, move the capital T over and generally plug in at various data points to solve for variables, and note that when t equals 0, the term e to the kt equals 1.
Wait, you're stalling, I already knew that! How do I get this open?
Why don't you just open the fridge?
No, too fast! You have to explain it in!
Okay, I don't know how long he has. I'm sorry, please don't hurt me, alright? I'm gonna call Mr. Solomon right now.
Hey, boss?
Hello?
Alright, how long does the body have? I took care of Mr. Davis.
Alright, Lawrence. So, what you gonna need to do?
We should first note that at 70 degrees Fahrenheit, the average person will die. The average human's body temperature is 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit, and the freezer is negative 5 degrees Fahrenheit. And after 1 minute, we found that his temperature had decreased to 96.909 degrees Fahrenheit. And using those numbers, we were then able to solve for P, and we discovered that it is 93.6 degrees Fahrenheit. Using P and previous values, we solved for K, and discovered that K is equal to negative 0.018. Using that K, we were then able to solve for the value of T, for which Y is equal to 70 degrees Fahrenheit. And T is equal to 20.001 minutes. So, in 20.001 minutes, his body temperature will have decreased to 70 degrees Fahrenheit.
So, in the end, he had about 20 minutes, and that was 15 minutes ago, so I'd say 5 minutes.
Gosh darn it, I dropped my phone again.
It's okay, Lawrence, you're free to go. I imagined Lawrence Reed differently. Okay.
hell? What am I?
Hey, Hansol, are you okay? You okay?
I just had the weirdest dream. I dreamt that I was Mr. Kushi.
What?
And I killed all my students. Apparently they got 4s on their AP test.
That's terrible.
They were in their speedos.
Ah!
Oh,
God.
Oh!
Well, I just wanted to make sure you're alright. You need a ride home or something?
Nah, dude. It's okay. I just need to cool off. I'll see you later, man.
Alright. Shucks! Saltzman! Wait! Hansol! Where does he live?
Yes. Middle class wealth.
Money. Oh, yes. Money.
Oh, the nitwits. I was wondering when you would come, but you brought only a spray bottle?
It's time for you to die! Goodbye, Mr. Saltzman.
Looks like it's right down the middle.